Krushnaa Patil. I'm from Bombay, India, and I'm a mountaineer. I started with climbing Everest in 2009. I used to be a professional dancer before that. I have done my education, I've done my bachelor's in political science, and I'm pursuing my MA in political science currently. I also hold a diploma for mixed media art and contemporary Indian dance. Mountaineering, you know, changed my life. I got into mountaineering in 2007 when I did my basic course, and then my advanced course, and I was just hooked on. I was obsessed. I did the 7 summits after that, and one short of them, McKinley, is yet to be done. And I've done many other adventures since then. I've cycled on the east coast. I've gone from Kolkata to Kanyakumari, and the west coast of India, from Mumbai to Goa. I love India, and I think I love to explore it in every way possible. I think the Ganga expedition gives me the chance to see Ganga like nobody else can. The vision that I have for this expedition is that we need to lay a foundation for the next generation to understand what is going on. The Ganga is a very, very important part of even the economic condition of our country. Its social life, its religious aspects. It is such an important part, and yet it is so neglected or so spoiled that we've forgotten. So this is a very important message that we want to communicate to the next generation, for them to be able to make changes that will impact the nature today. The Ganga is obviously a goddess in Indian mythology. The gods of the world had prayed to Lord Indra and asked for her to be sent to the earth because there was no water. And Indra said that she is so fierce and she is so strong that she, you know, the earth will be destroyed if she just, you know, if he just lets her flow onto the earth. And so Lord Shiva says that I will take her in my hair, and then she can fall onto the earth. So her fall is you know, divided, and so Ganga comes to the world. Basically, Ganga is a goddess that, you know, brings life to earth, you know, brings people back to civilization. She brings reform and form into your life, and I think we have forgotten that. We are developing industries and we are developing so many things that we've forgotten the most basic things that our Indian culture propagates and teaches us all the time.